Hello, and welcome back to Route 85, our show for iOS developers, because we love you too. And the second part of our series on how to open web links in Google Chrome on iOS. Now, in the previous episode, which you should watch if you haven't, I showed you how to detect if the user has Google Chrome installed and how to open a link in Chrome if they do. But I'd like to explore one other feature that we haven't covered yet, and it's the one that's probably most important to you app developers, which is the ability to add that nice little back button in Chrome that takes users back to your application. I know it seems like a small thing, but going back to your app with one press as opposed to going through the multitasker, it's really nice. Now, Chrome does this by taking advantage of an emerging standard in the iOS development world called X callback URL. This is a convention that allows applications a little bit of two-way communication. What you're basically doing is, when you open a custom URL in another application, within that URL, you're also telling the target app what your own application URL scheme is, so that when the user is done doing whatever they need to do in that second app, that application can open a new URL with a custom scheme that points back to the first app. The whole thing's actually pretty clever. So what does this look like in real life? Well, let's take a look at our Google Chrome URL. Here it is, it's pretty basic. But now instead of asking it to open the host www.google.com, I'm gonna ask it to open the host X callback URL. This is basically the signal to Google Chrome that, you know, hey, I'm gonna give you some information using the X callback protocol so that you can swap back to my application when you're done. After this, I'm gonna add the action open and then pass in a URL argument called URL that equals the link we want to visit, or I guess more accurately, the URL encoded version of that, so you end up with something that looks like this. Now, if I were to actually open this URL, it would work. In fact, let's try this right now in our sample application. So here we are back in my Open in Chrome example application, and I'm going to create a new URL along with this Safari and Chrome URL that I'm going to call my callback URL. And it's gonna look fairly similar to my Chrome one. Got an URL, URL string, except that my string here is going to be Google Chrome S. But then for my host, I'm gonna go with x-callback-url. I'm gonna add the action open. And then I'm gonna say URL equals https://www.google.com. Now, this won't quite work because I need a semicolon, because I need to URL escape these three characters here. So let's do that as well. This should be %3a, %2f, and %2f. Does anybody know if Xcode will automatically URL escape strings for you? If so, let me know in the comments. So anyway, lastly, I need to make sure that I replace my Chrome URL here with my callback URL. Oh, and I guess it'd be nice if I spelled URL correctly, huh? Wouldn't that be nice? Let's fix that. Edit all in scope, and I'll change that to URL. That's better. All right, now I can run this on my device. And when we click on this button, we can see that, yes, my URL opens in Chrome. But there's still no back button pointing to our app. And that's because we haven't actually told Chrome anything about the app that called it. Now, in order to do that, we need to register our own URL scheme. The same way that Chrome declares that it owns any URL beginning with Google Chrome, we can declare our own custom URL scheme for our example app. So let's do that now. I'm gonna go back to Xcode here. Let's open the project and check out the target. And over here in the info section, down here at the bottom, there is this section called URL types. This is where our application can declare any URL schemes that it can open. So let's expand this, and right now there's nothing here, but let's click the plus sign and add one. So identifier here is a human readable version of our URL scheme. Most developers that I know just seem to make this their bundle ID, so I guess I'll do the same. So com.google.openinChromeExample. And of course, feel free to replace com.google with whatever is appropriate for your organization. Now, URL schemes here, this is the string that is going to go before the colon that we say we are going to own. Now, this should be unique for your application. Now, if you're an application like Chrome or Google Maps that's expecting to be called by many other third-party apps, you could try something like a variation on your application's name. But if you're really only registering this URL for situations like ours, where we're going to be telling the target app what our URL scheme is, and we don't expect a lot of third-party developers to know it, I think it's generally safest just to use your bundle ID, maybe without the periods. So we'll do something like this. Com Google open in Chrome example. And make sure I spelled this right. Yeah, it looks good. I'm going to copy this because we're going to use it later. So now we've declared that any URL that begins with com Google open in Chrome example colon whatever will open up in this application. So now that we've done that, let's go back to our callback URL. I'm going to open up viewcontroller.m here. And here's our callback URL. And we're going to modify this. So I'm going to continue this on another line because we're getting a little crowded here. And the first thing we're going to do is add an and x-source equals my app argument. So this is a human readable version of our application name. And in Chrome's case, it's going to use this value to determine what text to put in that little back button. And again, we need to URL escape this, so I'm going to replace that space with a %20. The next thing we're going to do is add an x-success argument. Now, in the x callback world, this is a URL that our target app will attempt to open once the user is done doing whatever you wanted to do in that app and things have proceeded normally. Note that in Chrome's case, it's going to use this URL whether or not the page you're trying to open has actually opened or whether it's gotten a 404 or whatever. It's always going to use this success value. So for the value of our success argument, we're going to set it to a URL that points back to our app, which in this case is our custom scheme. And luckily I copied it, so I'm going to paste it here. Com Google open in Chrome example with a colon at the end. And again, that colon needs to be escaped, so I'm going to replace it with a %3a. And so now we have this much larger URL, but one that has an xsource argument and an xssx argument. So let's try running this now and see what happens. So I'm going to click this button now, and looky here. It's open in Chrome, and now there's this back button. The title is equal to my app, which is what we specified as our source. And when we click on it, it now goes back to our application. So that's pretty awesome. Incidentally, if you notice that your Chrome browser does not have a back button, the most common reason for that is that what you've added as your xsuccess URL here does not actually equal what is in this URL types, URL schemes section. Chrome does its own UI application, can open URL check to determine whether it should display that back button in the first place. And if this value in the URL scheme does not match what you have put in here in your xsuccess argument, it'll say, oh no, I can't open that URL, and it just won't show the button. So let's review that giant URL one more time here. Whoa! So the Google Chrome URL scheme at the beginning is asking us to open Google Chrome. The X callback URL host is warning Chrome that it's about to receive an argument in the X callback URL form. The open action followed by the URL argument is telling Chrome what page to actually visit. And the X success argument is telling Chrome what URL scheme to open when it's all done. And finally, this X source argument tells Chrome what text to put in that little button that takes the user back to your application. So this is great, but we're not done yet. See, it turns out everything we've just done, it doesn't actually work if you've got a version of Chrome that's a few years old. Admittedly, not a common situation these days, but it could happen. And let's face it, our code is starting to look a little messy here, and it might even get messier before we're done. But not to worry, we're going to deal with both of these problems in the very next lesson. So stay tuned.